you ready for the chase now. Take it out, don't let it slow. Today is Wednesday, and I am 4 days out from the NPC Kentucky State Open, which is 40 minutes from my house. And I really don't know what it's like ever to wake up in my home 4 days out from a show. I'm actually gonna get it, wake up in my home 2 days out from a show. Like, I'm used to being a mess. Not a mess, but so systematic in the fact that I've gotta pack for like a week of travel. I've gotta prepare so far in advance for food and potentially overpack food because I don't know what I would possibly need, and I'm not gonna have to like grocery shop when I get there. Like, I'm literally gonna put a miniature suitcase in my car, and I'm gonna drive 40 minutes down the road, and I'm gonna compete. And I just found out that for the first time, my coach is going to watch me compete. It kind of makes me nervous, but it makes me excited. But I'm also not used to like having that many loved ones and people I care about in the audience, because I've always competed far away in Miami or Vegas. And so, you know, I'm lucky to have my husband in the audience occasionally. He's never even been there but like twice for me. So this is all very different. I'm so excited. I'm so supported by people I work with. My limbs might come. So like, this is just a different experience. So I'm just gonna kind of just take it all in all weekend. And just be thankful for the fact that I'm doing a show that doesn't require as much stress on me, which is very awesome. And yeah, so I'm just sitting here. I'm reading. So my new book, you guys like to know what books I read. So I'm reading Girl Code, and it's The Secrets to Success and Happiness for Female Entrepreneurs. So it's a good book. I mean, I'm gonna finish it because I can't not finish a book. I have this weird ability to not finish a book, but it's not as much of a like motivational self-help book as I thought. It's more women sharing their stories, which is great. And I love that, but I also like, you know, more motivating words, and I love good writers. And so to read various stories from women and just question and answer format, it's not as, it's just not my style. So good book recommendations, comment below, because I'm almost done with it. And I just want a little bit something better. But the You Are a Badass was awesome. Loved that. And I loved Mastering Your Mean Girl. Those are right up my alley. So anything along those lines, comment below. But anywho, I'm gonna get up. Hershey and I have been chilling and sleeping. I think he's like truly gonna, he's hanging off. Like half of his body is not even on the sofa. But we're gonna go do cardio, because I only have two sessions of those left too. Bye-bye.
Strength Podcast. This week I interviewed Rob and Dana Lynn Bailey. A lot of you I know aren't familiar with these guys yet, but they are huge in the fitness industry. Dana Lynn is probably best known for being the first professional physique competitor in the IFBB. She's won first place.
Sure. And I think that a lot of the girls out there, I mean, I'm not going to speak for them, but I don't feel like a lot of it's that's them. That's them just trying to get followers, and it's not knowing any other way to do it. And it's just, it's sort of sad to watch. And I think a lot of times, like, actually good athletes get lost in the mixture of just being, like, an Instagram girl when there has to be more there. Like, you have to have some kind of skill that people are interested in. And
certainly.
Don't be confused by the likes.
Yeah, it's not that I'm mad at them, and it's just I get passionate that Dana can do it, and I think that other girls can do it, too. Mm-hmm. It sucks that it's not going in that direction as much.
Right. The sad part is that when the likes run out or the followers slow down for however long, their cups are not full, right? Because they're using that social media attention to fill their cup. And that's the truly sad part. That, you know, there's plenty of ways to do social media, but especially if you spend if it's such a large part of your business or your life in general, as it is mine and it seems to be yours, you have to be authentic.
Okay, so just got done with my cardio, and I got the notification about the Brute Strength podcast featuring Daniel and Bailey and Rob Bailey yesterday, and I was like, oh my god, this is perfect. I've been wanting to, first off, have a new Brute Strength podcast. I really enjoy listening to that. When I first had the conversation with my coach about switching over to the NPC and my apprehensions of why I left the NPC, when I first started, I did do two shows in Kentucky, actually three shows in Kentucky, and I did the Arnold Amateur. And then I did one Fitness America show within that, and I just kind of found that as my place at the time. But when we decided to make this move and this pull for, making the transition back over into the NPC, I explained my apprehensions and why I had left and what Fitness America did for me. So basically I had sought after Fitness America because of how they did their judging and, the exposure that their athletes were getting in magazines. And if you've watched my I Gave Up vlog, then you kind of know a lot about my story and about where I am as an athlete now and how things are a little different for me. Back then, that was my goal. So being in front of judging panels that were magazine editors and talent agent scouts and stuff, that was the objective for me. I needed to be in front of people who could potentially give me exposure and make that goal happen. And with that said, those judges aren't necessarily looking for, or not understanding the aspect of conditioning and of the athletic physique that now the NPC is doing very well with, as far as, conditioning and picking out the most conditioned physique. And it's, we don't have to do theme wear in NPC. So it's not really it is about stage presentation, but there is more overall judgment on the body and the physique and the comparison of the physiques on stage than there is in my federation. We don't have, in my previous federation, we didn't have call outs and things like that to compare, one physique to the other than the previous 10 that went out with you. So just things are a little different. And like I said, this myself as an athlete is my first and foremost goal now. I don't really care much about other aspects of the fitness industry. It's not been a huge push of mine to be a sponsored athlete, to chase different avenues of income of that nature. I really am passionate about my coaching. I'm really passionate about my training, and I'm really passionate about being the audacious athlete that I want to be. So I was a little apprehensive. I don't want to play into, the social media stuff. When I first started, freaking Instagram wasn't out. Snapchat wasn't out. Those things weren't a thing. Like, it was a Facebook page, if that, that you had. Or, yeah, I think even MySpace. Like, in that podcast, Dana Lynn, she started out in this at the same time I did. Like, those things didn't exist. We didn't have the pressure to have all of those things that we had then, or that we have now. So, I was just a little apprehensive about the NPC and about being an NPC bikini competitor, because A, the back pose, I'm not comfortable doing it. I'll just be flat out honest with you. If you follow me on Instagram, you'll know, like, I don't post rear shots. I rarely post a shot of me in anything other than my contest bikini. When it comes to bikini, if I post a picture in, you know, a mirror pic, it's from the side view at the very most. Like, I don't want my post to be over-sexualized. I don't want to be an over-sexualized athlete. That's not who I am. I'm not that in person. In fact, I'm probably the least sexy person in person. And I even try attempt to be, and I make a fool out of myself. So, you know, I love being glam, and I love dressing up, and I love makeup and girly things. But when it comes down to it, like, I'm a scrub most of the time. I just explained some of those apprehensions to my coach, and, like, he brought up a really good point, and he was like, Dana Lynn Bailey is one of the female athletes in this industry who have not cared what image she should portray and how she should be, and she is just the athlete she is. And, like, going forward, I am just the athlete I am, and I'm making this transition because I want to be in front of judges that are going to compare me against the most conditioned athletes that exist in our in bodybuilding right now. Like, I deserve to be compared to them. I deserve to be on that stage and be my hard work be judged on that, because, to be honest, you know, those opportunities I had with Fitness America, I don't think that they were to ever come into, I don't know. Like, I don't want to say that I just never have been a strong pursuer of things that I wasn't necessarily passionate about. And when it boils down to it, is like, did I want to be in a magazine? Yes. Do I train like those magazine workouts? No. So me going in and writing a magazine style workout for the average female, I mean, I can ride them. I've trained clients who are lifestyle clients. I can ride them, but that's not how I personally train. So if it's a feature on me, then why would I falsify my training to appeal to a mass audience? So that's just kind of, I've always just kind of had this battle internally with, like, okay, this is what I potentially want, but this isn't who I am. So, like, I'm truly embracing who I am now as an audacious athlete and just rolling with it. And so if I'm speaking to any females out there who are apprehensive about, you know, the sexualized nature of bikini competing or the sexualized nature of the fitness industry in general, like, please reach out to me. Like, I can share with you, you know, in the 5 years I've been doing this, the ebbs and flows, the struggles, the triumphs, the positive energy you can bring for yourself and how to kind of battle that negative energy that you might feel. So I didn't expect this vlog to go this way, but, like, just the parallels happened to happen. My coach, you know, he used Dana Lynn Bailey as, you know, a female example for me to make this transition and be okay with it and be strong in who I am and what I believe in. And then this was the podcast that I was like, got the notification for yesterday night. So I knew I wanted to listen to it. So now here I am, giving you guys a little bit of a spiel, but sometimes you like these, so yeah, I don't know. But anyway, so I'm very confident in what I have going forward. I love being the athlete that I am, and if my takeaway from this is, yeah, please reach out to me if you're just getting started or just looking at this and not knowing where you fit. Stay true to you, be authentic, and be genuine, and it's not all about the followers. It's not all about the sponsorships. It's not all about the publications. Like, it really, when it boils down to it, you have to be comfortable with who you are when your head hits that pillow at night. And if you are, then you're successful and you will be successful at this. And success isn't determined by those things I mentioned before. It's determined by being happy within yourself. So, yeah. So now I'm probably going to work out with a wonderful person, and you're going to get to see her on my channel, and you probably already know who she is, and so get excited for that, and we'll see you guys during the workout. Why can't So look who I have! So I think you and I moved here in the exact
same time.
You guys have asked for us to do a workout together or a vlog or do something, so we're doing it.
Look at this nice soap dispenser.
I know.
So pretty!
So everybody meet Evelie. You probably already know her. So say hello. And she's got beautiful shoulders too.
Hello.
Yas.
See, I feel like mine like dwindle in comparison compared to yours. Like I'm just sitting here.
No, it's okay.
I'm like, and you're really tan.
Well, but I'm, I don't know, I'm old. I don't even think you know how old I am.
I'm a youngin', I'm a baby.
Yeah, I'm 31.
I'm 21.
Oh, hello. 10 year difference. So we're gonna do this.
So this is what I'm going for in a decade. And this right here is
yeah,
what I'm going
she started
for
earlier than me, so she'll get there before me. But so this is the workout that we're gonna be doing. This is my final peak week workout, and it's mainly for blood flow and pushing them carbs to the muscles. So yeah, you guys can try this one, but it really doesn't serve a purpose unless it's peak week, to be honest.
Right. Or you just want a good pump.
Yeah, that's true. Good pump. But you'd have to have some carbs in you, I guess. Mm-hmm. So we're going to do this.
Here we go.
And try to film workouts. I'm a believer. Oh, glory. I'm a tribal. Wild horses. Wild horses. Wild horses. Run faster. Run faster. Run faster. I don't understand how nobody's commenting about the bikini girl with the pectoral striation. I was like, that'd be me.
You're like, hi. So, well, you have to work out without the camera. You've got to.
Muscles are like glossy. Saying it's all right, oh glory, I'm a believer. Oh Lord, I'm holding tight, but wild horses, wild horses, wild horses, run faster, run faster, run faster. Hello!
Hello! So we are done with our workout. And I have a really bad habit of actually looking up there instead of there. So I'm gonna be better. So she's gonna teach me a bit better because she's really good at that.
Oh, thanks.
And
no,
she
I'm
always has,
I always look at this thing.
And she always has beautiful hair. And working out with her made me miss my long hair. Oh, no. But we had so much fun.
Yeah.
And we decided that we really like working out together. So we're probably gonna do it more often. Maybe not with the camera always. But we did it for you guys.
Yeah.
For the people.
Yeah.
But she is really fun.
Because we love you.
Yeah. But she's really fun. And
yeah,
now,
she gives me hope for like what I can be like when I've had more years.
So there's 10-year difference between us. Yeah. 10 years.
Yeah.
And she started way before I did. I was slinging beers this way.
How old were you when you started training?
Training for competitive bodybuilding 5 years ago. So 31 minus 5. You do the math. It's peak week. I can't. 26. So it wasn't until I was 26 that I started competitively bodybuilding and like really focused on like hypertrophy training. Mm-hmm. Before I was an endurance athlete, I did Tough Mudders, and I really think I just did that so I could drink at the end. I mean, that's the honest truth. Like, if you've been following me for a really long time, you probably know that I was a bartender in college, and that's where it all started. So, 10 years.
That's solid.
She's starting now. Yeah. So like,
yeah, I
watch
started,
for this one.
Yes. Oh, thanks.
Well, watch for this one. You already watch her.
Hi.
I'm sure. And she's already been like on the national stage.
Hey.
And come, like,
literally points.
I know. Points. I know how it feels. I know what it's like.
But hey, it light, if you need anything to light your fire,
it'll
try
be points.
Failing. Yeah.
It'll be
by
if
points.
You didn't fail.
Well, I missed my card, and that's what I wanted.
Yeah. True.
You know.
True.
So it's like it's. But I think I needed to not get it to relight my fire a little bit. You know.
I see.
You know, because it gave me like purpose. Yeah. Like
I feel like
purpose,
if I had got my run for two, because I technically failed at mine too.
Mm-hmm.
I failed at my goal. If I had gotten my pro card in figure, I probably would have given figure pro division in Fitness America a shot before I made the call to run for NPC. So I think everything happens for a reason.
It really is blessings in disguise.
It is. Mm-hmm. So now I'm going to make a run for something a little bit more competitive.
Yeah, something different.
And I
and
think
you're
going to
slay.
And I never tell people to like.
Yeah.
The video,
yeah.
And I never tell people to subscribe.
Oh, shoot, girl.
I'm terrible about that.
It's all so, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, leave a comment below, and subscribe to her channel.
Thank you.
That's my answer on everything.
Because I don't do that. I never tell you to subscribe. So you're just being told what to do by her.
Drill Sergeant, Em Dunc.
Em Dunc. And bye-bye.
That's a good thumbnail. Yes. I'd hope.